Hi, my name is Elena, and I'm a software engineer at Tinybird. In this talk, I'm going to show you how to take advantage of real-time analytics within your own products using just Next.js and Tinybird. A great example of a product currently using real-time analytics is Vercel. They provide a great platform for developers to build, deploy, and preview their own apps. But they also offer Vercel analytics, so you can understand how each one of your end users is experiencing your app in real time. So let's see how you can do this with your own apps. For this talk, we are going to use Next.js Commerce Starter Kit, and we are going to add real-time analytics to it. If you are unfamiliar with it, this is a pre-built Next.js project that you can connect with your headless e-commerce API of choice, like BigCommerce, Shopify, or others. So let's start gathering the events that we are going to use. Each event will be a JSON object that we will post to Tinybird. Initially, events would look something like this. These are just the initial fields we'll start working with. Don't worry too much about them, as we can add as many fields as we want later on. First of all, we are going to create a new data source to store our events by uploading the JSON file with some rows. Tinybird guesses the columns out of the JSON objects, and you can then simply hit the button and boom, it's done. So we're going to start sending just a few events, but you can see later that these data sources can scale indefinitely. Now let's see some code. This is the root application file. Let's modify it. We've included the Next Tinybird library, so we can start sending events right away. When calling the Tinybird function, it's going to send an event every time a page is loaded or every time the user switches to a different page. We only have to set up the Tinybird provider component with the values we need, which are the API URL component, the token, the tracker library, and finally the destination data source, which in this case is named events. Okay, so now we navigate into the different product pages, we'll be sending events to our data source. If we check now our dashboard, we see how the events data source has now been filled with the new page load events. Cool, so in order to explore the data we'll be generating, we're going to create a Tinybird pipe. A pipe is where you work in Tinybird. It's like a SQL-based notebook where you can change your SQL queries and that you can use to explore data, transform it, or build API endpoints that you can consume. In this case, we are creating a pipe named getProductsRanking, and we are going to use a simple SQL query to get the visits count per product by counting each page load visit, filtering the product URL, and grouping by the product slug. By clicking on Create API Endpoint, we publish a new API endpoint for this use case. This endpoint will allow us to sort products on the main page by most visited. We can see what this endpoint returns by calling our API simply here in the browser. So now that we have created our endpoint, let's use it in the application. We have a trending section that is now manually created, so let's try to make it work based on the actual analytics. We need to modify the getProductsUtils function to call the endpoint that we have just created. After that, we can modify the product ranking based on the results from our endpoint. Finally, we're going to add the ranking number in the product tag, so we can see it next to the product name if present. If we take a look at the results, we can see how now the products are sorted, and we can see the ranking of each product next to its name. Now, let's see one more example of something useful that you can do by using the power of real-time analytics. If we see that users are drawn to certain images, wouldn't it make sense to put that once first? Let's see how. Let's edit the product slider component. By using the Tinybird utility again, we have to modify the onClick callback from the slider. We'll send an event named clickProductImage, and we'll include the URL and a new field, the product. This information will come from the product view component as a data attribute. Now let's click on some images randomly, and after that, let's go again to the events data source. We can see that Tinybird has automatically detected there's a new column, the product column. So we only have to click in the button to add this new column. It'll be empty by default, but as we start clicking on the images, this column will be filled with new information. So the next step is to create a new endpoint called get most clicked images. So we can sort the images the users have clicked the most. We do that by filtering by event name, but we also need to filter by product ID since each page shows a different product. So how can we do that? At Tinybird, you can add custom parameters to your queries. In this case, we are adding a product ID parameter. If this parameter is not defined, it returns all the products. Otherwise, it will return only the selected product. This templating system makes it really easy and quick to have dynamic endpoints for your application. So let's modify again the product view by using the data component. This component allows you to render other components based on the results of a Tinybird endpoint. We only have to set the endpoint name and send the query parameters we need for this endpoint. In this case, the settings are get most clicked image as endpoint name, and product ID as parameter. After this change, when the view component is loaded, it will sort the images based on the response. Let's click on some images randomly. I'm going to click more on the last images, so when we refresh the page, we are going to see that this image is now in the first position. So this is just a quick sense of the kinds of things you can do on the page. But now that you have your data coming in, you can do so much more. And more importantly, you can scale this up as much as you want. Let's see how. So we've implemented analytics based on the events coming from the page, but let's say you want to scale your application as it starts to get more and more data. Let's say we have transactional information coming through Kafka. These events are coming through a Kafka topic, so let's bring it to Tinybird. We'll start by adding a Kafka connection and connecting it to a topic. It is as simple as that. The key point here is that we can use this data source in the endpoints we have created before, as one of the key benefits of Tinybird is that you can work with billions of rows, just like you would with a small amount of data. For example, now that we have created a data source from Kafka, let's build an analytics project from scratch that uses the events that we are collecting. We can see how the events demo data source is now receiving data constantly. This one in particular already has 640 million rows, and it has received 62 million in the last hour. For this project, we are going to use our command line interface. It enables you to have your project safe in your local environment and structure it in different files. Data source, endpoints, pipes, so you can work with it as with any other software project. For example, this is how the endpoint that we have created before, the get most clicked image endpoint, looks like in a file. And it is really easy to upload it to Tinybird. By using the Tinybird command line interface, let's push our files by doing tbpush. We can see how the project is being uploaded. So as soon as it finishes, if we go to our new Tinybird workspace, we are going to see that all the data sources, pipes, and endpoints are there, and we can start using them for our application. But first, let's take a quick look to the data flow for this project. We can see how the different data sources and endpoints are connected. We have the events demo data source, which is the one receiving data from Kafka, and we have created a materialized view that filters the columns and the information that we don't need and stores it in the events disk data source, so the endpoints can work even faster. All these endpoints that we have just pushed are going to power an admin page for our e-commerce application, so that using the very same data that your application generates, you can understand how your application is performing in real time. We are applying different filters like the product size, the category, the color, or the device where the events were registered from. As we can see, each time we apply a filter, we are calling our endpoints, sending the needed parameters. And yeah, this is happening over those 640 million events that we saw earlier. Hope you enjoyed this talk. If you want to know more about how to build applications over billions of rows, email us at hitinybird.co or sign up to get an early access to our common developer plan.